So hi, Seth. Thanks so much for joining me here. This is awesome.
Hey Marissa, how are you?
Fantastic. So I have a lot of questions here. You're a very interesting person. So let's get into it. Why did you name your company JOD? Or how did you come up with that name?
JOD stands for just one dime, and literally right down the street from here where I am right now in the Austin area, I walked around with a dime. This was a time in my life when I was $24,000 in debt, and I was really struggling. It was putting pressure and stress on my marriage, on my parenting, on my four kids, and I worked for the richest company in the world, for Apple. And I was a manager of a tech support team for 20 to 25 people across the US. We all worked from home. And even though Apple is a great company, I knew it was not the right company for me. I knew there had to be a better way. And I was so tired of logging in every day and spending the majority of my time in a spreadsheet. It's just, it wasn't rejuvenating. And even though we made decent money at Apple, for the things that I wanted to do with my family, it wasn't enough money. And I thought, what if I went out and I just started with a dime and I use the law of exponential growth and I double it just 20 times? And so I would walk around, Marissa, and I would ask people. I would walk up to someone like you and say, "Hey, Marissa, how's it?" Well, I wouldn't know your name, but "Hey, how's it going? You know, what's your name?" And, you know, "My name's Marissa." And I would say, "How many times do I need to double this dime to get to $100,000?" Or I would say, "If I doubled it 20 times, how much do you think it would be?" And they would say, you know, "Oh, 400 or 500 or 6,000." And it's actually $100,000. And so I started doing this. And after getting up to right around $400, then I started investing that money. And it ended up becoming a very massive Amazon and eBay business that made us well over $1 million underneath a year, within a year. And that's when I knew, like, this is so much like the opportunity, the freedom this gives me to be able to take my wife on a date, or to go anywhere in the world, or to be able to know I'm making money while I'm sleeping. So I got this idea, like, I need to start sharing videos, showing people how I did it. Because I remember going on YouTube and trying to find videos, and so many of them were just talking, you know, maybe 1% value, and then 99% of the time they're just talking about some course or some, you know, hook or some sales call. And so I thought, I'm just going to go provide tons of content. And so I did that, and as a result, people started asking me to coach them. And it just grew from there, and today it's just one dime.
So you sell on Amazon now, but you coach, you do both.
Yes, so I do both. My primary income is Amazon, secondary is eBay, third is Instagram, and then I work with a team of 9 coaches. They're all Amazon sellers and very successful. And by successful, I mean some of them do over 20,000 a month revenue at 40 to 50 to 60% profit, and others do well over $1 million a year. And so, like, one of them did, he broke over 200,000 in Christmas just in that month. So these are very successful coaches, and most of them own multiple businesses as well. So they're not just selling on Amazon, they have other stuff they do. They're entrepreneurs. They have the heart of an entrepreneur. They understand business, they understand risk, they understand the ups and downs and the heartaches of what it means to be your own boss. And they're all different. They all have different strengths and weaknesses. So when you combine what I know with what they know, and we all together coach people and show them how to do what we do, that is just one dime. And today I'm proud to say we're in 89 countries around the world, and we're helping people who, like, literally people in Kuwait, people in Australia, people in New Zealand, people in Guatemala, teaching them how to do it from their laptop, how to build a business on Amazon. And I'll tell you, Marissa, it's a lot of people out there will say it's easy. It's not, it is hard. But compared to working 9 to 5, you know, being poor is hard, being rich is hard. So you have to choose your hard. Which do you want? You know? And I'd so much rather be an entrepreneur and go through the pains and struggles of that than the other side of boredom and monotony and, you know, having a tracker for a tracker for a tracker of your tasks working for a corporate company.
So now when you started at the beginning, so when when you were just starting out, did you have any mistakes that you made that you would kind of tell somebody that you're coaching to
Yes.
avoid?
Yes, very many. I will try not to talk too long in this part, but one of them was, one of my strategies is I got a list of hundreds of suppliers. It was right around 900 suppliers. And every day I would call a number of them on the phone every day. And I would say, tell me what are the best selling products? And my thought was, if they tell me the best selling product, that's the product I'll source and start selling on Amazon and eBay. And I created a spreadsheet and I would give it a grade. And so let's just say for out of 100 suppliers, if 10 of them said you should be selling pins that go on shirts, you know, but 12 of them said, oh, we are selling the most e-cigarettes or vapes, something like that, then that would tell me that the vape industry is the new moving, exploding industry. The problem with this strategy, Marissa, is even though it helped me somewhat and it taught me a lot about suppliers, my problem was I was assuming they would tell me the truth. And not all suppliers will. Some would recommend products that later what I would find out are dead. And they're just trying to get rid of extra inventory. So it's not an effective way of telling someone, of finding out what the market is doing, because the supplier doesn't know the market as well as the buyer. I needed to be listening to the buyer. So that was one of my first mistakes. Second mistake was not differentiating enough. So on some of my very first products, I didn't differentiate. And by differentiating, I mean I didn't make sure that I was fulfilling a need. I thought, oh, someone else is selling it, I'm going to sell it too. And that cost me a lot of money. Ultimately, $20,000 within the first short time of selling on Amazon. I ended up making much more than that, and it ended up being a costly mistake, and I learned from it. But if I could go back and ask myself, what would I do different? And I would say this to anyone out there selling Amazon. If I search the keyword for your product on Amazon and a whole bunch of listings come up,
right,
your listing needs to be so amazingly, obviously better and superior that of course I would buy yours. That it's fixing a problem no one else is. And that right there, I think, is the biggest need for Amazon sellers. They call it Me Too products. It's like, hey, this product is selling really well. Oh, I'm going to sell mine too. But it doesn't work like that. Just because someone else has success doesn't mean it transfers over to me, because they already have reviews. They already have ranking. For me to get to that level will take months and months and thousands of ads. So it's better to build a product like theirs, but make it better and fix a problem that theirs isn't fixing. Now people have a reason to buy mine, even if I start out with no reviews.
So is that kind of what influenced you then to go into coaching and to start, because you saw these challenges and how you overcame them, became successful? Is that what influenced you to become successful?
So it is. So when I originally started doing YouTube videos, I had no plans for having a course or becoming a coach. But ever since I was a kid, I loved teaching, and I'm good at teaching, and I love communicating. So when I started doing videos, my friend said, Seth, you should just start a YouTube channel and share your life. And there was no discussion about, hey, sell a course or build that. I just thought, yeah, why don't I use YouTube as a platform to teach people? Because it's fun and I have time to do it and margin. Because on Amazon, once your product starts doing well, you over time, you spend less and less and less time on the product because it just keeps selling for you. Unlike when you have a 9-to-5 job, where you have to go in order to get paid. And when you stop working, you stop making money. It's different on Amazon. So when I started doing videos, people, and it started with like literally a neighbor down the street asked me, said, will you coach me? And I remember, never forget, we had her over, my wife, and I sit down with her and talk to her and stuff, and we started helping her. And then family members started asking me, two of my sisters asked me for help, and I just started to help people. Then it got to a point where I was getting so many requests, I had no time left to do anything else. You know, I still like to go to the gym. I like to drink tea. Back then it was coffee. I like to, you know, hang out with my family. I like to go hiking. I like to read books. So I thought, you know what, if I'm going to continue to help people, I should start charging. And so at the beginning, I charged very little. $25 an hour was my fee. Wow. But I kept getting requests. So I just kept raising it and raising it and raising it. And I always almost feel embarrassed when I say this, Marissa. And the reason is not because I think I'm some special person. I worked for my success. I busted my ass to get there. And I charged $1,000 an hour. And I had to get it to that number just so that I would stop getting so many requests. And if someone really wanted to meet and they want to spend that much for an hour, I will make it worth their time. I'll help them in every way I can. But it got to a point where it was so expensive that no longer am I getting a call every day. You know, now it became just a few times a month. And it gave me margin to still work on the Amazon store and have a life outside of that and coach people.
Going along those lines, what is the first piece of advice that you normally give to somebody completely new who decided that they wanted to start selling on Amazon?
Yeah, these are really, really good questions. First piece of advice I would give to someone brand new to Amazon is, number one, you need to, it's a mental piece of advice. You need to decide if you're all in or not. You need to decide, are you, if you're dabbling, if you're like one of those people who goes up to the pool and they stick their toe in the water and they're like, do I want to jump in? You need to be the person who goes in the diving board and jumps off and does a flip in the air and goes all the way in. Or another illustration, you go into the room, you shut the door, you lock it, you throw the key away. I'm in, for better or worse, I'm in, and I'm ready for anything. It has to be a mentality. People who test it out never succeed. People who say, I'm going to make this work, even if I have to walk through hell, I will make it work. Because there comes a point where the workload goes down and the success goes up and it gets easier and easier, almost to the point where it gets boring. And I even shared this on Instagram this morning. There is a point where Amazon actually gets boring. I hate to say it, but it's true. But that's when you understand it so well, it's become automatic. And now it's just a matter of, okay, let's launch a new product, and it's just numbers. And if you know the numbers, your chances of succeeding are very high. And you won't be 100% successful with every product. I wish I was, I'm not. But my ratio of success has continually grown over the years because I keep doing it and learning from it.
So I appreciate your honesty. You know, a lot of people, they just go, oh, you'll be successful no matter what. But yeah. Right. So now, are there any, talking about FBA, Amazon FBA, are there any advantages or disadvantages when it comes to selling there based on where in the world you live? Or can you do it if you live in the U.S., live in another country? I mean, does it matter?
Yeah, it absolutely. Awesome question. So it does matter. Let me start by saying you can sell on Amazon from anywhere in the world. We have people who live on little tiny unknown islands, and they're living off of their Amazon income. They live on an island out in some tropical area, islands I didn't even know about until they joined our team. Like, oh, tell me about this. So I went and Googled it to find it. So you can do it from anywhere. It is harder. It is more difficult to sell on Amazon if the country where you live is not the Amazon country marketplace where you're selling. So for example, if you live in Canada, it's easier to sell on Amazon.ca for Canada than it is Amazon.com. However, you still can do it. So if anyone out there listening saying, well, hey, Amazon isn't available in my country, it doesn't matter. It's available to you. You just have to take a few extra steps to get there. And we teach exactly how to do that in our community, because we have tons of people doing it. Like I mentioned before, we're in 89 countries. People from all over the world are doing this. And even some of our coaches specifically do not live in the place where they sell. So they've had to walk through that process. Then they turn it into documentation and videos and then show you step by step how to do that.
A lot of people say, you know, there's the 4-hour work week. There's all these different work smart, not hard. How many hours a day do you think it would take to run a business like this if somebody just wants to start out, build a 5-figure income?
Yep. Awesome question. So I'm going to have 3 answers depending on 3 scenarios. Number one, if you have a regular 9-to-5 job, don't fire your boss yet. We talk about firing your boss. That's our dream. Every time someone gets to a point where they can fire their boss and they share that in the community, there's like all these shots of celebration and happiness and party hats going off. Like, yes, they did it. You know, and each time it's awesome. But don't do it until Amazon's making you enough money where if you have to live on that income, it's going to hurt your business. It's like, you know, if you're on an airplane that's going down, you first need oxygen before you oxygen someone else. But if you remove that from you and now you're sharing oxygen with your Amazon business and that's all you got and it's not much, your business will suffer, but you'll scale slower. So if you have a regular job, find someone who can help you not make mistakes. It could be just one dime. It could be anyone else. There are really good coaches out there. And give it 2 hours every day, 6 days a week for a full year. That's what I always recommend. Marissa, I've never seen a single person who did that who didn't succeed. And by succeed, I mean get to either 500 a month or over $1 million a month in revenue. And of course, that depends on the person, how much time they give it. But by succeed, I mean they went from zero to something significant. So that's my first advice. Second, if you do not have a boss, like you have enough money to live on, or you know, you're doing Amazon full time, or you just have enough for a year, let's just say that. And so you can work on this full time. Then give it all the time you got, because the more time you give it, the faster it's going to scale. And it comes in stages. When you're searching for your product, it takes a while. After about a month, you can find that product. Then you decide to source it. That takes a lot of time. Once you've talked to the supplier and you're waiting for it to ship, you're just waiting. So you're not as busy. So now you spend your time looking at other products. So your work will help to to overlap and double itself if you do it that way. But one more thought on this. This is the third answer. There's always more work to be done at the front end and less on the back end. And by that I mean, for the first 3 months, there's a lot more work to launch. But once you've launched, now you're doing, like right now, okay, this morning, I logged into Seller Central. I looked at our products. I looked at the PPC ad campaigns. I tweaked and changed just a few things. It took me just over 10 minutes. And we did $3.5 million revenue. That's not profit, but still close to 60% profit revenue just last year. So you just go in, you log in, and you're just tweaking. Now, the things that do take me more time, and we try to do this every month, but we don't always succeed at it, is we'll try to launch a new product every single month on Amazon. That takes a lot of time. But once it's going and running, there's very little you need to do, and that gives you free time. That's why we right now have time to talk about this.
So I see a lot of coaches out there saying that, I could do this, I could do that. But what do you have that's different? What makes you stand out?
Yeah, two things. We are very real and honest, and we have a strong sense for BS. So we're very blunt. We don't sugarcoat stuff to make it sound easier, then people get disappointed. It is hard, it is hard, it is hard, but it is so worth it. Okay, that's number one. And those are the kind of coaches I hire. They're coaches who help people without ever asking for anything in return. They love to give and help, and it creates a community. The community is unbelievable. It is very, okay, I'll just give you a specific example. So a while back ago, I was going through our group, our private Facebook group for this program, this community, and someone asked a really, really big question. Like, it was a difficult question. There were 56 responses to that one question. And these aren't BS, sarcastic, critical, responses. These are people trying to help. Not to mention, there's 9 coaches monitoring it. So I guess there's 3 things. First, we're very real and down to earth. 2, the community is there to help you, and they will help pick you up when you're struggling. And 3, to my knowledge, Marissa, there's no coaching program out there that offers as much live coaching as we do. We don't just sell a course, goodbye, see you later, and then they're off on their own. We do have a course, but we're updating it every single week. We're either adding new videos or tools. We're updating it because Amazon keeps changing. Second, we provide 6 hours of live group coaching every week. So like when someone gets the pro membership, they get that for a full freaking year. Wow. So that's how we're different, is it's tons of live and it's different coaches, myself, other coaches, which means you're going to get a really rounded out perspective on how to succeed.
You add a lot of value there to your clients. Now, who would be your ideal clients, and how, I mean, you've kind of covered this part already, but how would you help them specifically?
Yeah. Ideal client, Marissa, would be someone who takes ownership. What I mean by that is when they're struggling, they don't blame the world. They don't blame mom. They don't kick the dog. They don't say, oh, it's where I grew up or how I live. They say, you know what? Yeah, people do things that aren't fair. That's true. But I'm going to take ownership for my success, because this thought hit me just the other day. I was working out, and I left the workout to go write this down on my phone. Your greatest competitor is not on Amazon. And I'm speaking to anyone who's selling Amazon out there. Your greatest competitor is you, because you are the only person who can keep you from succeeding. So people with that mentality, those are ideal. Those are we actually have a filter system, and most people are not even aware of this, when it comes to people joining our community. We're very picky about that. And then how can we help them? A to Z. It doesn't matter. We've had people join our team who are doing over 7 million a month. We have people who went from 0 to over 7 million a month from our teaching. We have other people who've never even bought on Amazon before. It doesn't matter what your knowledge is. We will help you with the next step. So if you're advanced and you start, yeah, there's a lot of stuff you already know, but then you're going to say, wait a minute. I never heard of this hack. I never heard of that trick. Wait, what about this? Oh, can I talk to that supplier? How do I get, like, there's so many things when you have a combined people. Like, you think about, imagine being in a room of 2,000 people and everyone's helping everyone. Like, the combined knowledge, not to mention the courses and the coaches teaching it's beyond a description.
How do you coach people to create a passive income on Amazon?
So we teach them to be very, very picky about the products that they launch. Because if you launch a product that is either not profitable or is not differentiated, it's a me too product like I was mentioning before, then your chances of succeeding are really low. Second, we teach them have this mentality. It's like you go into your garage every day and you're building this machine. Mm-hmm. And you're spending a lot. And the machine's not doing anything for you. You're just building it and you're building it. And then finally one day it starts printing you money. And now all you have to do is give it a little oil, tighten a screw. that's the kind of Amazon business we teach. Not buy and sell, buy and sell. No, it's build a brand that sells for you. So the idea is that Amazon is not your boss. You don't work for Amazon. Your business works for you. It serves you. So you can set your life up the way you want. Like literally, Marissa, and I do not say this to sound all cool, because there's a lot of videos out there. Hey, look at my Lamborghini. And like, and it's like they're so in love with their image. It disgusts me. That's not me. It is simply, I understand how much you have to sacrifice to get this point. I literally could fly to New York right now or go to Europe right now if I wanted to. And it's not because I'm special. It's because I worked for it. My Amazon business supports me to give me that kind of freedom.
How do you find high profit products to sell on Amazon?
Yeah, I'll give you some tips. I'm going to share everything, no problem. So one of my favorite methods for doing this is find products that people, that solve problems that people are already using a manual method to solve. So for example, every day, my wife Kimberly takes lemon rind and she throws it into the garbage disposal in the sink. Now, it's, you know, when you turn it on, it gives all these weird sounds, but actually makes it smell fresh. What if someone said, hey, we came up with this little pod, this little pill thing, little packet of lemon rind, you drop it in there and it does it for you. So instead of having to go get a lemon and peel it or go buy lemons, you just have a box, you just drop a new one in. That's a great example of that life hack, I believe she found online. Why doesn't someone build a product that does it better? That's one of my favorite methods. Number two, and I'm only going to share part of this one, you can use an ad campaign on Amazon to find what shoppers are searching on Amazon that no one else is selling. And that puts you way ahead of the competition. It's so traditional to say, hey, find products in Jungle Scout that are already selling and make yours better. And there's value in that. Mm-hmm. And we still do that and it works. But what if you built a product that people are searching for that no one is selling? You're so far ahead of the competition, by the time people realize what's going on, you already have the majority market share.
So what other services do you provide to Amazon sellers other than coaching? Do you provide any other services?
Absolutely. So we have an office in China and we provide full sourcing services. We provide shipping and logistics. If people need someone to inspect the product, they can. One of the scariest parts about selling Amazon is you're sending money to someone overseas, and 90% of the time it's to China. Nothing against China, but there's not a lot of trust between Westerners and the Chinese culture. And so, and people get nervous, and their business ethics can be very different than other countries, and for better and worse. So we have a team there who can help you with that. There's a lot we do. I'll just leave it at that for now. But the main things we do is the coaching is our main thing, but we also do help a lot with the sourcing side.
All right. So tell me a bit more about your sourcing. Are you launching a trip to China or?
Yes, we are. In September, we have a team of people who each person will get their own personal shopping assistant who is bilingual, speaks Mandarin, speaks English, who will walk with you or you and your spouse or you and your business partner through the marketplace in Yiwu, China, and help you source. And then every evening we come back to the hotel, we meet in a room, and for 2 hours, myself and other coaches from Just One Dime will teach you right there exactly how to use that data to launch products and to find new products to launch. And so we're very excited about that. It's going to be for a full week. One of the days is going to be like a day and a half. It's going to be a fun day. We're going to go on a train that goes super fast called a bullet train. We're going to visit different centers. And we're going to make sure everyone knows Chinese by the time we get back home. Just kidding.
Wow. So you have students from outside the U.S. under your coaching?
Yes. We're in 89 countries. We have a large population from Australia, a few from New Zealand, a lot of people from Canada, United Kingdom, a growing population from India. We have people in the Middle East, a lot of people from Israel, people from South America now, the random islands I was telling you about, some people in Ukraine, Russia, Germany, France, Italy, but United Kingdom, Canada, the U.S., and Australia are the four primary, most people from there, and then growing populations from the other countries.
Wow, and in U.S. dollars, how much can they expect to make?
Anything from a dollar, and I'm not exaggerating, I'm dead serious, anything from a dollar a month to multi-million a month. We have people, students now, who are doing better than I am on Amazon. And I'm proud about it. It makes me a little bit jealous, but I'm proud about it because it's like parenting. You want to raise your children to do better than you. Well, in the same way, a coach wants their team to be better than them. They can slam dunk the ball better than you, you know, but you still need a coach. The coach may not be the very best on the team. I'm definitely not. There are students, some of them are beyond me, but we're good at teaching you how to do it and combining sources to help you with that. So, I mean, the sky's the limit. That's what I love about it, Marisa, is you don't have to, when you work for a company, there's a cap. Like, oh, I got my 2.5% raise. I remember at Apple, I would make them sometimes more money in a day than they paid me in a year. And then I would get this little tiny raise, and I'm like, man, if I was doing this for myself, I would be so rich. So why am I working for someone else? And again, Apple's not bad. I learned some great stuff from them, but it just wasn't the right fit for me. And I don't like all of the corporation political stuff that goes on as a company grows. I like it when people are just super down to earth and real.
So you love being a coach then, I mean, after having those other experiences. So what to you is the best part of being a coach of Amazon sellers?
Seeing people's lives changed. And by that, I don't just mean making more money, but seeing their character change, their ownership, their self-discipline, their freedom, their marriages, their relationships, their children getting involved. It's like, you know, we are so much more than Amazon, Marisa. It's about a lifestyle. It's about a way of life. It's about improving the quality of who we are and our relationships. So it's that whole, even some people are like, man, after being just one time, I'm now working out again. Someone else said, I'm now running again. Like, it's a way of life. It's a way of thinking that impacts everything you do. It's saying, look, I can be so much more than I expected myself. Why not change that? So Amazon is a means to that. But it's not the only way. There's eBay, there's Instagram, there's e-commerce. There's so many other things. There's drop shipping, there's pallets that you can do. There's freelancing, but it's more about the quality of life. So when I see people do that, that makes my day more than anything else.
Thank you so much. This is inspirational. Now I want to look into this. I've looked into it before. I've heard things before, but it always kind of seems scammy, but you make it seem like it's a really real awesome thing.
Thank you. We're real people. We're right here. I'm a real person. We have ups and downs like everyone else. So there's nothing. I like to say this too. Like, I used to think of entrepreneurs who are really rich, like, oh, they're special or they're scammy or they're, I was always suspicious until I had to walk through hell to get to that point and realize, wait a minute, some of these people went through a lot of shit to get to the point where they understood how much they need to grow up on the inside. To be an entrepreneur, we have to grow on the inside. Then we grow on the outside. It's like internal change and then you see external change.
Well, thank you so much for your time. This has been awesome and very educational.
Awesome. I enjoyed meeting with you and thank you. Appreciate it, Marissa.
Thank you.